first of all, you know, I respect teachers very much. So just namaskar to you all. And we'll begin the
namaste,
session.
Ma'am.
Namaste,
namaste. You know, ma'am. What is physiotherapy? I was telling, you know, it is from the small babies to the elderly people. We come in all the branches of the medicine. Like we treat pediatrics, we treat orthopedics, we treat neurological cases, we treat cardiac and respiratory cases. We are most important part in a sports physiotherapy. So there are so many fields we are working in. And today we are going to focus more on the postures and which small tips, you know, if you follow that, then you can have a pain-free, long life, working life. And physiotherapy is also without medicine. It is only with the exercises and some posture correction. Our aim is to bring the client to the normal function or the near normal function. As you all know, daily stresses we face, you know, like we have to stand for a long time in kitchen. At the end, I'm going to give all the exercises, what all we can do for that standing, which gives you pain in your legs, heels, and everything. We'll talk in detail. Then you have to do a lot of bending, twisting, cleaning. As the in pandemic time, no servants were available. So you all have to do all the work of the house. Plus, as your teacher, so you have to take online classes and everything. So we are really stressed with all the work. The climbing stool, desk job, social media as phone, laptop, tablet, computers. See, usually women are more affected than the men because they have to work on different tasks, you know, like they have to look after their house, they have to look after their children, and if you are working, then you have to do your office job and everything. So many fronts she has to be. So she is more stressed, and because of the stress of the work and everything, she is more prone to get aches and pains. So like a woman is always caregivers, like more than competent to men or equal to men, you may say, and career oriented nowadays. Similarly, also they have to travel in these crowded trains, work in the offices with the computers or the desk job. And that results in some ache and the pains. So now, you know, like you all know, this is a spine, and it is very important organ of our bodies. All the organs are important, but the spine is utmost important because it is holding the spinal canal like a tracer, you know. So the column, vertebral column, makes a column, and from there the spinal nerves are going through, which are very delicate. Okay. We have to protect them, and God has given us a protection in means of the vertebral column. So in vertebral column there are three to four parts. One is cervical, 7 vertebrae, cervical vertebra, 12 vertebra, thoracic vertebra, and another 5 lower vertebra, the lumbar vertebra, and last 5, which we call it tailbone, is a coccyx vertebra. And common problems we face, you know, like being a teacher, the neck and shoulder pain is very, very common because you have to work like seeing the notebooks, writing on the boards. So all these activities give you neck strain, which results in your neck pain and the shoulder pain, sometimes back and leg pain, knee pain, heel pain. Osteoporosis we will talk a little later, and the deficiencies also we are going to cover. So this is the, you know, like wrong habits. Posture is very important part of our life. Posture is to carry yourself in an erect manner when you are standing, sitting and walking. Here you can see the correct posture and incorrect posture. The first girl, she's bending from her upper back, her neck is also jutting out, which will give her problem of the neck, shoulder and the back. So, and another thing, postures plus stress. Stress is also most important factor because it also gives you a lot of pain in the neck, because whenever there is some tension in the head, neck is the closest part and neck muscles go tight. So the stress also gives you pain. Of course, stress gives a lot of problems. Not only the pain, it affects your physical and mental health also. And heels, high heels if you wear, then also you have a heel pain, obesity, pregnancy. As you tend, your posture gets changed in the pregnancy period. So that also gives you back pain, some congenital disorders and trauma. Trauma is if you have a fall or accident or something, which also gives rise to problems. So now we'll talk in detail in the postures, you know, like we will start from the morning. Some people have a habit of getting up straight, you know. So when you are getting up straight, what happens? Gravity, you have to get up against the gravity. And when you are getting against the gravity, you are loading your upper cervical, your cervical spine and your back, particularly the upper back and the lower back also. So it is always good to turn on one side, take the support of both the hands and put your legs down, and with the support you get up. And whenever you want to lie down, also sit on the bed. Same way, go to one side with both the hands support and then you lie down. See, when you're working in the house, so if you bend like this, you are again putting compressive forces on your spine, which gives rise to problem. But see, if you stand like one leg folded, one head is supported on the washing machine or whatever things you are taking out, on the platform or something, and then you bend from your hip, so your spine is straight and you don't get any spinal problem later on. So it is a very small change you have to make in your posture and you can remain pain free. Now sitting here also, see, the first slide is showing you are sitting slouch anywhere. So you are again loading your lumbar spine, and here you get pain, backache. So you have to sit right upright, and your buttocks should go behind. You first, you bend yourself, push yourself behind with your buttocks. Let your buttocks touch first and then the body. And your foot should not be hanging. You know, they should also have a footrest or something so that your full body is taken care of. See, when you are reading, writing, or as a teacher, you have to correct so many papers and all, books and all. So if you use some slant board, like C is using, your book is in slant position. When it is in the slant position, you don't have to bend your neck or you don't have to extend your neck. The neck is in proper posture and you don't strain your neck. So, whenever you are doing this, you can just see if you are nowadays you are using computer, you know, like laptop or the desktop, put your screen little slant so that you don't strain your eyes, don't strain your neck, and you will be pain free then. See, now here we are seeing different posture in standing. First is a correct posture, good posture. Now second, if you see second figure, his neck is coming out, you know, like chin is jutting out. And usually the good posture is when you are carrying your head, shoulder, it should be in one line with the heel. Here you see the head is ahead of the heel. So there is a lot of pressure on your neck. Then the second posture is a kyphotic posture, where you are bending from your upper back. And with that, again, your that head is forward. And you are going to have a pain in the neck and the upper back. Now, third one is, this is a hypercurvature of the lumbar spine. It is called lumbar lordosis. Here also, the buttock is just falling behind the heel. You know, they are not in the straight line. So you again going to strain your lumbar spine, and you may get the backache in this posture. Here you have flat back. There is no curvature at all. There are normal curvatures. Normal curvature is a little bend in your lumbar spine. Huh? So in this way back also, your spine is getting stretched in the lumbar region, and you are going to get a backache. So you have to be very, very careful in postures. Next. Now, sleeping postures. Some people have a habit of sleeping on the stomach. So here you are straining your neck and the back. Whoever has a neck pain should never sleep in this posture. This is the ideal posture where you are sitting, sleeping on one side. Your one pillow is under the upper back and one pillow between the knees. You are lying down supine, flat. So that time, many have this lordosis increases, lumbar spine, and you strain on your lumbar spine. And whenever you have cervical pain, neck pain, you know, that time, many a time doctors say that don't use pillow. But instead of pillow, you can use a towel roll. At the end, I'll show you how to make a roll. Or now also, if you want, I can show you. Take a Turkish towel and fold, two fold, three fold. And then you have to make a 3.5 fold. So this portion will come in the neck, and the flat portion will come to the head, so that your neck is very well supported. So never sleep without pillow. Pillow is most important. Otherwise, what happens? You are always straining your neck because neck doesn't get support. Next. Here also, see, sleeping on the side, but you can see the posture, you know, like see her head is behind. She is bending, your curvature has increased at the lumbar spine, so that neck, back is getting strained. So other posture, she's sleeping properly. Her body is in alignment. Head, shoulder, back, and everything is in alignment. Now, this is most important part, because nowadays, because of the online education, you are using a lot of computers. Otherwise, also computer use is increased. So you can see faulty posture. You know, when you're slouching in the chair, your back is getting rounded, so that your normal curvature is disturbed, and you're straining your neck as well as your back. So if you have a proper chair and you sit right back, like buttock, see the buttock. Buttock is behind. And then you rest your body. Your neck should be at 5-degree flexion. It should be not extended or the flexed. So if your screen is little slant, your neck will automatically be in a proper posture. Your shoulders should be at zero. and your elbows should be at 45. So those who are using laptops, you may have your keyboard separate. And you can use, like we used to have a table, you know, where you had the keyboard compartment. You have to pull it so that your elbow will be at 45. And your screen should be a little slant. So neck should be proper. Otherwise, you will have this type of neck, you know, neck jutting down. And you're straining your neck. Or you will be looking like this. So again, you're straining your neck. Please make little correction and you will be all right. This is again the ideal posture, you know, ideal chair, if footrest is for the foot, proper. Your eye level should be at the end of the screen, top level of the screen. Your eye level should be at that. So you, again, you have seen all the shoulder, elbow, and the neck posture. See, we have to do a lot of lifting in the house when you're working in the house. So always remember that you are not directly bending and lifting. Always sit down near to the object, carry the object near to your body and slowly get up with your straight spine. Household also, you can do the same, you know, supposing if you want to take something from somewhere. So always bend with from your knee and take it out the thing and then straighten up. See, now most important part is neck, you know, because as you all are teachers, so you are using a lot of computer, you use in school, you have to use blackboard, you have to correct the notebook papers, and a lot of neck work is involved. Either you are bending constantly or you are extending your neck. So when you are using blackboard, you must use from a shoulder level. You should never use, you know, upper part of the blackboard so that you are not straining your spine. And computer and all, we have already talked about, you know, the posture of the spine. So most of the time, the spine and shoulder problem are very common in the teacher. And they are more common in the woman than the man. Now we'll see the causes of the neck pain. One utmost cause is the posture. Like poor posture. When you are using your posture is not proper in using a computer, laptop, or whatever work you are doing. So what happens? These muscles, they get tight. And tight muscles, they are, you know, like they lose their elasticity. And they cannot take any strain. Little bit of work and you'll get the neck pain, the shoulder pain. So this is the most important part. Before you get cervical spondylosis, it is the posture related problem which gives you neck and back pain. So please and please and please you use your correct postures to avoid the pains and getting into the cervical spondylosis. Now cervical spondylosis is what? It is a normal wear and tear of the joints, like two vertebra, upper vertebra and lower vertebra, they make a joint. And as the age grow, like at the age of 40 and above, this between the vertebra gets degenerated. So that we call it cervical spondylosis. And you don't have to fear of the cervical spondylosis. See, if you work on your muscles, you work on your proper postures and do your regular exercises, this is a normal wear and tear of the body and which will not give you any problem for sure. You can contact, if you have any problem, you can contact your physiotherapist, learn proper exercises and care, and you'll be pain-free. Then third is a trauma. Trauma is, you know, like you get some strain while doing some heavy work or something, or you had a fall or an accident. Then muscle strain, again, because of the wrong postures, your muscles are already shortened and tight. So a little bit of work gives you strain. That also gives you pain. And we stress also, we talked about the psychological stress. and you teachers have a lot of stress because you have to manage so many children. So today we'll talk about the postures while exercise, you know. So you also will get benefited, and your children whom you are teaching, they will also benefited, because nowadays it is seen that younger children, you know, with the faulty postures, and they come up with the pain in very early age. So you all can help them in that. So stress, we again going to talk. And this tumor and neoplasm, they are the conditions which, you know, very rare condition, doesn't apply to normal population. So that is that. So now we'll see the normal spine, how it will look. See, these are the two vertebrae which I talked, and in between is the disc. It is a spongy material. It takes all your strains, you know. It works like a buffer. It protects your spine as well as the nerve which is passing through the canal. So this is normal, and here you will see the X-ray of the cervical spondylosis, where your height of the disc is reduced because of the wear and tear, and which is very normal process. And you get the spikes, if you see, that is also sign of wear and tear. Bony spikes in your vertebra. So this is all is workable if you do proper exercises and postures. So that is definitely going to take care. You don't have to get worried about the cervical spondylosis. Next. So now neck pain. Cervical spondylosis is a degenerative disease, as we talked, of the spine, vertebral disc, ligaments, and cartilage. Discs of the spine may become, as the age grow, the disc becomes the water content of this becomes less, and it becomes dry, and it loses its elasticity. So again, the power of getting holding the strains becomes less. So you are susceptible to get pain. Usually cervical spondylosis starts after the age of 40, but nowadays because of the wrong postures, you know, always if you see, you know, people are in their mobile phones, so they are always bent. They're bent at their neck, they're bent at their upper spine, and they come with the pain at very early age. Like sometimes in 20s also, we get the patient with the cervical spondylosis, which can be avoided if you take care of your postures. And as I said, it's an aging process. See, now sometimes, you know, you get acute neck pain. Sometimes in the morning you get up and you get up with the pain, and it is so severe that, you know, like you cannot hold your head also. Like getting up also, you have to take somebody's help. It becomes like that. So sometimes what happens if you are not sleeping properly, and in sleep, some posture is, you know, like you have taken for a long time some odd posture. So the disc gets strained, you know, it gets stuck in some position. So when you get up with this acute neck pain, what do you do? First is you do ice pack, and your body will protect you with the spasm. You know, you'll feel everything is tight, you cannot move your neck, but that is a normal protective spasm of your body to protect you from the further problem. So always have two to three times of ice pack. Don't do anything in that day, you know. Like if you are doing some exercises, stop all exercises when you are got acute pain. If it is very serious, you can use cervical collar and take the physiotherapist help. This we talked about the neck and shoulder. Now let us come to the low back pain. Here again, the posture is the vital sign, and that gives rise to back pain. We will see further.
Here
Israelis notice that 84 to 90% of the people, they get low back pain in once or many times in their lifespan. And women are more affected. And women being a main part of the house, you know, like she's a main member of the house. She has to look after so many fronts, you know, like the house, the cooking, making her children ready in the time, sending the school classes, taking their classes, and so many things she has to do. So if she gets affected with the low back pain, she has to rest compulsorily. The whole house get affected, the whole family get affected. So today, you know, like you take these tips with you so that doesn't come in your life, you know. You can prevent your low back pain. Again, the causes will remain same, you know, like what causes you saw in the cervical spine, the same lumbar spondylosis is again the wear and tear of the spine. So your vertebra, your the ligaments, your disc, as you grow old, they are going to go in wear and tear. But if you're maintaining your weight, you are doing proper exercises, maintaining your postures well, so you can delay it. And you can, if supposing wear and tear, then also you can delay further deterioration. You can always delay, and you can remain pain-free for a long time. Again, if one lesion, acute disc. If acute disc also, it comes, you know, with the lifting, bending, traveling. Sometimes you are from the above, you are taking your very back, and that gives you strain or bending incorrectly. Many a times what happens when your muscles of core muscles and the back muscles are weak, and you try and bend something, bend and take something, you get stuck over there. And then you get acute pain because that time your disc has got strained, or sometimes it does prolapse. So in that, we'll talk when the exercise part comes, we'll talk about that also. Sometimes fracture usually in the, if you have a fall, or in the older age, when your spine is osteoporotic, little change in the posture on the strain, you get fractures. Infections you get like tuberculosis of the spine, but they have, supposing it is infection, then you have to be very, very careful. But their symptoms will differ, you know, like you have physical symptoms also. Sometimes there's fever, loss of appetite, loss of weight. And these pains will always come in the night and not during the work or the daytime. Usually the pain is more intense in the night. So that time you must go to a doctor, orthopedic surgeon. You should not neglect. Depression, we already talked. Obesity, again, your lot of weight causes the spine at the wrist because your muscles are weak when you're obesity. That means a lot of fat. Wherever there is a fat, your muscles are always weak. And postures, we have already talked. Then lifestyle and pain origin from internal organs. That is very rare, you know. Sometimes when you have some diseases inside, like uterus or stomach or kidney, that time also you have some back pain. But the mechanical pain, you know, you will always come to know. Like with the bed postures or wear and tear, that pain you'll definitely come. This is like, you know, spondy is the spine and losses is the problem. So this is a spinal problem. Degeneration of spine, of wear and tear of the vertebral joint, disc and ligaments. Here again, this is a lumbar spine. And this is a normal disc between the vertebra, the normal nerve passing through the canal. And the other figure, you see that pink thing, you see that disc is prolapsed outside and it is compressing the nerve. When it compresses the nerve, then you have acute pain in the back, spasms, and sometimes your pain radiates down your neck. because of the compression of the spine, of the nerve. So this is acute back pain. See, acute back pain, as we have discussed before, so it is not all the time disc, but sometimes because of the wrong posture for a long time, and long time if you remain in that posture, sedentary life, that time also when your muscles are weak, you get strain and you get the pain. Causes repetitive bending, twisting, lifting heavy weights, sedentary lifestyle, back muscles weak. You will see that usually acute disc pain appears between 20 and 40, and degenerative pains, which is wear and tear pain, it is usually 40 and above. Occurs while lifting, stooping, severe back pain and unable to straighten up, that we talked in that bending, while we were talking about the bending. Pain radiates when it touches the nerve. Your slip disc touches the nerve. You get pain in the buttock and the lower limb. It is called sciatica. Again, the symptoms will be as we saw in the cervical spine: muscular spasm, sharp burning, stabbing pain, radiating down the leg and the foot, pain. See, this is one sign, you know, if the disc, whenever you are coughing and sneezing, your pain will increase, or you will feel the pain, because then it is increasing, the pressure in the spinal canal increases. So coughing and sneezing gives a pain. This is a sign that something has wrong with my disc, and you have to take rest, complete rest for a few days and ice pack. Whenever such situation comes, if you have acute pain of the disc, you always lie down and take ice pack for 2-3 times a day and rest for 2-3 days completely. If it just little strain in your disc, or disc is little bulge, then you'll be all right within 3-4-5 days. But it is a severe, prolapse is severe. And that it may take time, but recovery is always there. You don't have to worry. Only thing, when your nerve compression gives you weakness of the muscle and the loss of sensation, that is the time of the alert, you know. Then you have to visit your orthopedic surgeon, and then you have to undergo whatever treatment is needed, and you have to undergo surgery also. Tingling numbness. When the nerve compresses, you get tingling numbness in the leg. So here, this is very interesting slide, you know. So see, whenever you are taking class, na, so in between, say after 10 or 15 minutes, you can just ask your students also to get up and put your hands behind the back and stretch yourself as just three to five times, and you also do the same. So you are also taking care of your back, and you are letting your children to take care of their back. And the simple, like, you can do this also, or after 10 minutes or 15 minutes, you can ask them just to stand. When you are there sitting, ask them to just stand. Or you can do the breaking of postures, like they are sitting, you can ask them to just stretch your hands up. That will also alter the posture, you know. These little things you also do, and let your children also do, so they will also always be taken care of their postures, and we are helping them to avoid the neck and back pain in the early ages. This is osteoporosis. Maybe if you are the young crowd, doesn't apply to you. Usually it comes after menopause. So say usually between after 40 or 50. Till then, what you do is, to avoid getting into osteoporosis, you like how we, for the future, we have a big bank balance. Money, we put money in the bank, and for the rest of life, we can use money for our better life. So here, same way, with the help of the diet, with the help of the exercises, you can really have a balance of the calcium, so that you don't go to that stage, you know. You will remain upright. Otherwise, when the bone becomes porous, you know, as you go grow old and you have not taken care of your calcium and vitamin D and all and exercises, then slowly you start going to get stooping. And the day comes, you know, many people, they stoop a lot, you know, like they go on and on bending because of the osteoporosis. And then osteoporosis is a silent killer, you know, it will not show any sign. But if you are severely osteoporotic, then you know, the day comes and you're turning also, you get the fracture. So this is most important and you have to take really, 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 you have to put it in your mind that what all you have to do to avoid osteoporosis. Next slide. See that we have seen the normal bone, healthy bone and the porous bone. Bone becomes porous. So it is very brittle, you know, a small, slight fall also you get fracture. So, as we said that menopausal woman, lack of physical activity, poor diet, smoking and alcohol, some medicines, you know, like steroids when it is given for some conditions of your body, that also give rise to osteoporosis. Now, we'll see how to avoid the osteoporosis. Next slide. See, diet and lifestyle is most and most and most important. See, from now, if you want to balance your calcium, you must have a lot of leafy vegetables, fruits, dry fruits. You can have our Indian food like ragi or nachni. You can have jowar, bajri, drumsticks. All those things you can include in your diet. Then you can have proteins like dal and all dry fruits and everything. And this third point is very important, sunlight. Sunlight you must have every day at least for 20 to 30 minutes. You can plan your walk such a way that you get a sunlight every day, except like how now it is monsoon, so sunlight, like we don't know whether the sun will come or not. But otherwise, we Indians are really blessed with the sunlight. We always have a sunlight. So you can take between mornings to afternoon 2 o'clock or from 5:30 onwards, you know, 5:30 onwards. Only 2-3 hours in between, you should not go out. Otherwise, any time, because nowadays what happens, some schools are also air-conditioned school, so they don't get the light and the sunlight. And houses are also with the air conditioned, offices are air conditioned, so that this part is missing, vitamin D. And nowadays it is seen that everyone is, you know, like vitamin D levels are very low in everyone. So I think we should take some time that we go out and walk in the sun. And some people, you know, have the people, they don't eat ghee and everything for putting on the weights. Some doctors have said no, not to take ghee and all. But ghee is most important because vitamin D is a fat soluble. And if you gulp the tablets, but you don't eat ghee, it's going to go in waste, you know. So always have ghee on chapati or whatever form you are going to have. But ghee should be must. And you can have a massage in twice a month or once a month or once a week as it is available to you. Next. This is also a very good exercise for your neck and back also. And shoulders, you know, you can lie down like this, put your shoulders out, hand out, elbow 90 degree, and just raise, supposing your hands are resting on the floor, you raise your upper body a little and the hand little, so that you are working on your, give me arrow here.
Hello?
Here, here, up here. Little up. There. So they are, these are the most important muscles. They are the scapular muscles. They are called the setting muscles, you know. So you can, with these muscles are strong, you can save your shoulders and the neck. Usually because of your all the time bending posture, these muscles are going to go weak and they are going to go tight. So protect our neck and shoulder, and we get neck and shoulder pain. So this is most important exercise for you. Whenever you have a back pain, you can do this half, Bhujangasana. Next. You can do full Bhujangasana also. This will take care of your back as well as, see, when you grow old, and we talked about the osteoporosis, na? Leg, you get weight bearing because you're walking on the leg. But hand, you don't get any weight bearing. So when you're pressing your hand and coming up, your hands are getting weight. Huh? And so that your bones become strong because of the weight. Weight exercise is very important in the later stages. So you can train from now also so that your bones remain strong. This is, you know, hamstring muscle because of the long standing faulty posture. Sometimes these muscles behind the knee, they become tight. So this is a very easy stretch. Now you lie down flat and fold one leg from the hip and knee. Put a band in your ankle to keep your ankle in the dorsiflexion, and then slowly straighten your leg so that you'll get the pull at your calf also, and your hamstrings will also get pulled, which will take care of your back, your ankle and your knee. You have to do just two, three repetition. This is also very good for your back. Cat and camel exercise, everybody knows. And here, you know, you can work on your core also. When you are in this posture, cat and camel, core muscles are also working, which are the most important muscles for your back. Change. This is again for the core and your back. So first you start with the all fours. When you are balanced in that, then slowly first you start with only lifting your leg forward. If you're comfortable with that, then just lift your leg behind. You know, you can do it in the part. When you are doing this for a few days, then you can do alternate leg lifting and the head lifting, which will again strengthen your core muscle, which will take care of your back. This is also very good. This is a bridging, which will take care of your back and the core muscles. Straight leg raising muscle you can do. And those who have knee pain, you can sit with the support against the wall. See here the back is not touching, but you can put one pillow and support your back also. Then put some roll under the knee and straighten the knee till the leg becomes straight. And you don't have to lift the knee. Knee should be in the contact with the roll, and then just straighten your leg, which will strengthen your quadriceps muscles, which are the main muscles for the knee. This again, it is called hip abduction. Now we are working on the hip. So if you do this hip abduction, hip extension, you are helping your back and the knee as well. This is again for the knee. Those who have a knee pain, and you teacher have to stand for a long hours. Na? So knee pain and the heel pain is very common for you. So this is very easy and best exercise. You have to stand against the wall, 1 to 1.5 feet ahead of the wall. Your legs should be a little away from the support. And then slowly slide your lower back down, so that you get 15-20 degree, 20-25 degree of the knee bend, and again slide your back up. So this will also strengthen your quadriceps muscle, knee muscle. And this is again for the knee as well as for the balance. You have to practice from now only, so that at the older age you don't lose your balance, because in old age balance is a problem, and because of that they have a fall and they have fractures and everything. So this is very important exercise. You have to practice every day one leg standing. See, you can do exercise in form of yoga. Wherever there is a possible yoga classes there, you can do yoga to remain fit, remain pain free. This also helps you in your stress. And nowadays we are in pandemic, so that stress, fear and anxiety is always there. So when you are doing yoga, you are overcoming all this, plus you are increasing your immunity gets increased with your exercises. So you can choose any form of exercises, either in the form of yoga or in the form of walking or cycling or swimming is out of question nowadays, but you can do cycling in your compound, walking in your compound or the on the road, or walking. And this is when the pandemic will get over, that time you can do underwater exercises, are very good. See, this is, you know, like when you are standing in the kitchen and you have to stand for a long time, so your legs get tired. So what do you do? While when you are standing in the kitchen, you can use small patla, you know, like for puja and all we use small wooden patla, na? So you can put one leg at a time on the patla so that leg get relaxed and you are standing on the other leg. Or else you can just do tiptoeing in between when you are standing, na? Stand on your toes. That is also again changing the posture of your leg. Or you can use patla, as we have said. Frequent rest break, yeah. And now I'll show you some exercises. Tanning ban kar pana exercise. First of all, you know, I'll show you some neck exercises. As we talked about the jutting neck, you know, because of the work posture and all. So, you
hello?
Move your head.
Salmali?
You move your head. Huh? Yes, Vikram sir.
Hello?
Haan, Vikram sir.
We are not able to hear.
Oh. All the otherwise you heard, na?
Now we are able to hear, ma'am.
We can hear.
Yes, ma'am, you are audible.
Okay. So now I'm going to show you one exercise. This is very important for
you are gone on mute.
Ma'am, again voice is breaking. We are not able to hear.
Ma'am, you are gone on mute.
Now it is audible?
Yes,
audible, ma'am.
Yeah. Please mute. Everybody mute yourself. Thank you. Am I audible now?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
So we were talking about this jutting neck, you know, jutting neck, jutting face. So usually those who are working sedentary in the office or the teachers, they... So what you have to do is your head is steady and you have to just move your chin behind like this. Many dancers also do this pose, or the pigeon, you know, like how you have to just move your chin forward, and we don't have to go a lot of forward, and this is your posture, you want to break that. So from here, from the neutral, you are going behind. From neutral, you are going behind. If you want, you can practice. I'll show the same exercise. So here, many people, you know, do like this. We don't have to move the head, just the neck. The chin will go forward and backward, forward and backwards. And when you are doing properly, na, you'll come to know that you'll feel little stretch in your upper vertebra, upper thoracic vertebra. The next we'll do some shoulder exercises to support the shoulder and the neck. So first and foremost, as we were talking about the setting muscles of the scapula, you can keep your hands, your shoulders at 90 degree, your elbow at 90 degree, you're coming in and going out, coming in and going out. Coming in and going out, which will take care of your scapular muscles, which are very important muscles for your neck and shoulder. Then you can have circling. First, you have to start from outward, up, in. Outward, up, in. The same way, when you finish 10 repetition, then you bring your elbows in, go right up and then turn. Elbows in, go right up and turn. Elbows in, go right up and turn. Right? Then you can do this. Raising your shoulders up and slowly bringing them down. Up and down. Up and down. You can rotate your shoulders behind. See, you are forward, upward, backward, and from there you are slowly coming down. These are most important exercises you must practice every day. And then you have to put your elbows touching your body at 90 degree and slowly go out, let your hands go out. And then I'm standing. Then you have to stand and put your hands behind, stretch them a little bit, and then straighten your shoulders. So usually people have this posture, you know, shoulders are bent in, upper back is bent. To avoid that posture, again I'm showing, when you are behind, hold your hands and one another. Pull them down. Then your shoulders should be straight. This you can practice in between also while teaching. You can also do one or two times. Let your children also do, so that they will also take care of their posture. See, you people are doing great job to make them a good individual and a good citizen. And just add one more. This is my request. While teaching, two to three breaks, you take a few seconds, you know, maybe 10 seconds, 15 seconds, and just let them do these exercises. When they are sitting, just they are raising their hands so that your full spine is getting straight. You can also do, let them also do just four repetitions, not more than that. Then you can just clasp your hand, stretching them. You can just do this side bends, come up, again do the side bend, come up. You can same rotate, come up, rotate, come up. So that will take care of your full spine and back also. Now I will teach you some heel exercises. See, usually teachers really have a heel pain also. So what do you do is, this is very good exercise. This you can do in the kitchen when you're standing for a long time, or otherwise also. Whenever there is a heel pain, first thing you have to wear a soft footwear. Your footwear should not be heeling. You should have just half an inch of raise, if at all, but no too pointed heels or a lot of big heels. No. And then you can have the stretches. Plus, first I showed you that belt exercises in figure we saw. That also is going to help your calf muscles. Calf muscle stretching is very important. Then you can apply ice. When there is a pain in the heel, you can apply ice. You can put one water bottle in the freezer and roll the bottle under your feet. See, usually this is a fascia, which becomes tight, you know. And fascia is very important, like from head to the toe, it is one piece. So stretching of fascia is very important. And if you palpate this muscles, this fascia is all tight, you know, you'll find lumps over here, lumps. Because of the posture, they have gone tight. So you can do this massage, the stretching of your toes. And while standing, full stretch. You come on your toes and stretch yourself completely so that full fascia from head to the toe is stretched. And if fascia remains flexible, then your injuries will be little less, you know. So the fascia will prevent you from the taking strains and any load, whatever, they can take it properly.